Okay, we're here at the research grounds of Wageningen University and Research in Wageningen. My name is Frits van Evert, and I will tell you something about the potato yield crop project, which is part of the Holland Innovative Potato Program. So we're standing here in a potato field, which is ready to be harvested. We've done a little bit here already. You can see the potatoes on the ground, but this is actually not as much potatoes as we would have expected. And the Potato Yield Cap project aims to provide farmers with tools to find out what could the potential yield be on their field and what is the reason that the yield may be less than optimal in certain years. This year, I can give the secret away. This is a sandy soil, which doesn't hold water very well. It's also been a very dry year, so in this field, water limitation is the reason why the yield is low. So a farmer is interested in what is the potential yield on this field. If I do everything well, if I supply the plant with enough water, nitrogen, keep all the pests and diseases away, what would the yield be under those ideal circumstances? And then in practice, the yield will usually be a little bit less than that. And then a farmer would like to know, what is it that I need to change? What is it that I need to do better in order to boost that yield? That is the main aim of the Potato Yield Cap project, to make that clear. Well, the first step in helping a farmer on the path to discovering what the yield cap, what causes the yield cap, is provide him with information about the field. And we do that with digital tools. So we have developed FarmMaps, which is a web-based tool where lots of information about fields is collected. That includes information about the soil type, satellite information, weather information, and so on. Every farmer in the Netherlands can subscribe to FarmMaps and has then immediately access to basic information. In addition, there are a number of fee-based services that provide recommendations about, for example, how much sideways nitrogen to apply, advice on variable rate, potato home killing, and a bunch of other things. Okay, I have logged in to FarmMaps. And so I can now go to my particular field here. Now I can see a lot of information about this particular field. So for example, I can display the height map of the Netherlands and that one for this field. And it shows that at that corner of the field, it's a little bit higher than where we are standing right now. I can show the soil map. And it's not a very large field, so it has just one type of soil here, but I can see exactly what it is. Now I've clicked on the satellite widget in our dashboard here, and I can see the most recent satellite image that's available. That's of 14 September, so a week ago. You can see that over that area, it's a little bit greener than in the other parts of the field. And by clicking here, I can go back through time and see how the biomass, how the canopy has developed over time. And finally, I can go to our crop simulation widget, which shows the simulation runs that have been made with a crop growth model for the whole season. And this one shows exactly the growth of the crop over time. It shows the distribution of the nitrogen in the crop, how much is in the tubers, how much is in the canopy. And it also shows how much nitrogen is in the soil, how much water is in the soil, and this gives a very detailed information about what's happening with the crop. Okay, a crop growth model is a computer program that allows us to follow the growth and the development of a crop over the whole season. It works by representing in the computer the current status of a crop, let's say today, in terms of how much leaves is there, how much tubers are there, how deep are the roots. And then based on that, together with today's weather, we can calculate how fast the crop will grow. And then we can calculate how much leaves, tubers, roots there will be tomorrow. And in that way, by repeating that calculations, always with the current weather, we can simulate crop growth from day to day over the entire season. And one of the advantages of this is that you can make things visible in the computer that you cannot see with your eyes. Another use of a crop growth model is that you can make predictions. So we can use a crop growth model for the situation, how the crop is right now. And then with the weather predictions for the next week or 2 weeks, we can make simulations and predict whether the crop will run out of water or whether it will run out of nitrogen in the next 2 weeks. And that might provide farmers with information about whether it's time to irrigate or to provide extra fertilizer. A next step in this exercise will be to consider also the information that we get from satellite images. So we have the crop growth model, which tells us how much tubers and leaves are there. We also have the satellite imagery, which tells us how much leaves are there. They might be slightly different, and using statistical measures, we will combine these two sources of information to come up with the best possible estimate of what is really happening in the field. If we can describe with a high level of accuracy what's going on in the field, using both our crop growth models and the satellites, then we can also give precise recommendations to farmers. So we have recommendation systems for variable rate soil herbicides, for variable rate potato home killing, for Phytophthora, late blight, fungicide applications. But I want to focus now on the variable rate side dress nitrogen application. So I can go again to my field, click on the satellite imagery. I get a list here of the satellite images that are available for my field and when. I choose this particular one here from the 27th of May. And by clicking here, I get a map, a task map that shows how much nitrogen is needed on the various parts of the field. And you can see in that part of the field, my application says it needs a little bit more nitrogen than in the other part. And the advantage of applying citrus nitrogen in this way, as opposed to no citrus at all or a uniform rate, is that you use less nitrogen overall. You get also a crop that is more evenly green and will more evenly ripen. When the crop ripens more uniformly, it means that the tubers will be of more uniform quality. That means there will be less damage during harvest, and the product that will be delivered after storage will also be more uniform and have a better quality. Okay, back to the field. We have a yield here. We've got some big tubers. We got some small ones. What we really want is, of course, only big ones. Our calculations show that it's possible to close the yield gap, and our software tools will give farmers the information that they need to achieve that in the near future.